What makes a pin go viral, or what is a viral pin? My name is Teresa Toledo. I am a Pinterest expert strategist, and I am gonna talk a little bit about viral pins on Pinterest. But first, give me a follow. Share your comments below. If you have any Pinterest-related questions, feel free to ask them. I will answer them one by one. And also, stay to the end. I am sharing below with you a tool, a free tool that you can download to get your Pinterest account started super quick. So, what is a viral pin? Well, we use this word a lot. We kind of overuse this word. And back in the day, and when I say back in the day, like 2018, sometimes you would pin something, pin an image, and for whatever reason, people would love that image so much that it will be, everywhere, and people would just save, 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 click, click, click. And I do recall in December 2018 having one single image that generated 8,000 link clicks to my client website, and that was like, oh my God, what is even going on here? And that pin, in that particular month, generated over 50,000 link clicks, and that pin never really died, never really stopped, and there was nothing magical or special about it. It was not promoted, it was organic. But that was before. Nowadays, it's a little bit harder to see pins behaving that way. And the reason is because the algorithm changed. The pin distribution within Pinterest changed. So we have to pivot and adjust. Now, I like to use the term that other Pinterest experts usually mention, like it's a legacy pin. I believe it's Monica Frost that says that, and also Kate All mentions that. So though there are legacy pins, which are a series of pins that always perform well for whatever reason, people fall in love with them and keep saving them and clicking on them, and they always keep giving. And sometimes those pins are ugly pins, are pins that you didn't even like or you didn't even put much effort on it, but it just never die. And they become somehow important on your website traffic. So how can you make a pin go viral? Technically, unless you're promoting it, putting some money behind, you have to rely on all the information that you put on your pin, how Pinterest distributes, how people see that pin, how people engage with that pin, and how the algorithm gets the signals that that pin is a good pin and should be shared, and so on. But there are a few things that you can do to ensure that your pins have a chance of becoming, very strong traffic generating pins. So, very first thing that you need to think about is the image. Remember, people are scrolling super fast. It's pretty much when like we're on the highway and we are driving to, those huge signs. They need to have something special to catch our attention. So, always use an image that stands out, that relates to the content, of course, because you don't want to mislead them. If you mislead them, they will click, but then they will bounce, and that's not a good thing. So you can use your own images, your own pictures, or you can use stock pictures. Make sure that your images always have the best possible quality, that they're not dark or blurry. They don't have to be perfect, but you want to always offer your best. Use text overlay. Even though for certain niches, especially if you have a product or fashion or design, decor, images without any text overlay, just the picture performs well because after all, people are searching for inspiration on Pinterest. Depending on your niche, you want to try both. You want to try images without text overlay, and you want to try images with text overlay with a little bit of copy that tells the pinner what it is that they're going to find once they click. Why should they click? What is, why should they even check it out? So make sure you have that. Now, when you are creating your pin with text overlay, make sure it's easy to read. Remember, most people are using Pinterest on their phones, little screen, so they're not seeing it so big. So make sure that the font is easy and clear to read, especially if you're using, some sort of script font that sometimes is hard to read. And also, you want to make sure that it's kind of sort of a call to action, you know, make people think, make people want. It's a teaser. Don't give all the information in your pin. Make your pin a teaser. Also make sure to use your keywords, not only in your pin title and description, but within the text overlay that you're writing on the pin. Make sure that the image that you chose relates to the content, because Pinterest has an optic reader. Pinterest can read the image, and if you are, let's say, using an image of, let me see, of a car, Pinterest will connect that image to other car pins. If you're using an image of a toy, Pinterest will associate that to kids or a toy. So always keep in mind those things when creating your images. And last one, make sure you pin your image to a very relevant board. You know, Pinterest has boards, and we always want to make sure that our boards are very specific. So do not put, you know, the very first time you're pinning, especially, don't put your image on a random board or a generic board. Put your pin in a board that is very specific and related to the content that will send Pinterest signals that what is that pin about, who should see the pin, where the pin should be shared with other pins, you know. So all of that is very important. Now I would love to hear your comments or read and your questions. Please drop them below. Don't forget to give me a follow and subscribe, and also grab the free PDF that I'm sharing with you, so you can get your account, Pinterest account, ready and running right away. Thank you so much.